Hello everyone, welcome back to a new video, a new episode of the playlist Understand American. Today I'll be talking about 33 normal things in the US that freak everyone else out. Now some of this is gonna be a little bit repetitive, especially if you saw the video with the 20 cultural differences US and Europe, but don't worry, it's still a lot of fun. Now this article is from bestlifeonline.com. I'm gonna link the article in the description, so feel free to go and read it, give me your own opinion, especially if you're American, if you're European, if you lived in both places, I would love to hear your own opinion. Now, before we go into the video, make sure to subscribe. I say it every single time, but I do need your support a lot. It's really, really important. That's the only way that I can grow and keep doing this and have a lot of fun with it and invite guests and spread some stories out there. So I would say hit that subscribe button if you haven't, and let's go into the video. All right, 33 normal things in the US that freak everyone else out. Number one is saying how are you when we mean hello. Absolutely. Now they call it when we mean hello. I'm not American, so it's hard for me to say. I'm just reading it the way it's written. But yes, saying how are you when we mean hello, it's a very, very common thing in the US. But yeah, it's definitely a thing. You hear it a lot. Number two, smiling at strangers. Now I personally can't really agree or disagree with it because I haven't really experienced it. I'm not American, so I don't know if I just genuinely smile at strangers. I might have to keep an eye out for people and see how they react. But it's also probably just being polite. I don't know what's up with that one, but please let me know if you know. Number three, flying flags everywhere. Yes, not just 4th of July. The US flag is everywhere. Every major building has one, every household has one. It's a very common thing, very patriotic nation, very important, the flag. So, yep, definitely you'll see it a lot if you come over here. Number four, rarely taking a vacation. Yes, but I think it has to do with people only get like 2 weeks off work, or three, or I don't know, which is insane, right? So yes, rarely taking a vacation. It's probably because depending on how much you make, you can't really afford to take a lot of vacation. It's that simple, in my opinion. Number five, I love this one. Drinking from red solo cups. Number five is super cool because as a European, we don't really have these cups, but we see it a lot in movies, like college movies, rom-coms, all these kind of things, and we just always imagine if that's a real thing, and it is, you know. First time I came over here, you go to a home party and you see those cups and you're like, it's like in the movies, it's amazing, you know. But yeah, you see that a lot. Number six, getting free refills. Will they talk about this in the cultural differences? It's a very common thing in the US. Most places you get free refills on sodas, on water. We don't really have that in Europe, so. Number seven, having a boring currency. I don't think it's boring, personally. Maybe because it's so old and it's never been changed, you know. In Europe, most of the currencies change every 10, 15, or 20 years. Of course, to take off the market fake money. It's the old bills, ever since they created them, I think. So, you know. I don't think it's boring personally, but it's up to you guys. I don't know. Share your opinion, please. Let me know down here. Number eight, carrying confusing coins. If they carry coins nowadays, because it's mostly just credit cards, then yes, they're very confusing. There is a one penny, maybe a two, five, then 10 is a dime, and then there's no 20 or 50 cents. It's a 25, which is a quarter. You know, it's America, no metric system, Fahrenheit instead of Celsius. I guess, you know, they just made their own thing and they have a quarter coin, which it's good for laundry. That's what I know over here. A little confusing, Maybe, but it doesn't bother me too much. Number 9, having 24-hour restaurants. Yes, a lot. It might also have to do with, I mean, I'm in Los Angeles, right? Big city. Most of the big cities in the world have 24-hour places where you can eat. So, you know, if you're a little bit in the countryside in the US, I don't think you'll find a 24-hour restaurant in a cornfield in the Midwest. You know what I mean? It's kind of relative, but in the big cities, for sure. But I think we have that in Europe too, right? So, nothing special. 10, carting people who are obviously not under 21. Carting people in general, like, you know, I mean, I'm not 17 and you can see it, my beard, I start getting wrinkles, like my time is going too, right? And I go to buy a bottle of wine and they ask me for my card. And then I'm like, I have my Swiss driving license. And they're like, no, we need a passport. I'm like, all right. In general, if you don't have an ID or a driving license, it's really, really hard to get something. Number 11, having cheerleaders at sports games. Yes, yes, yes. Cheerleaders in every major competition. It's, I don't know. It, again, as Europeans, we only know these things from the movies. So going to a sports event here, seeing cheer, but even in high school or college, they have cheerleaders, which is, I think it's super cool. I think it's fun. It's like a sports. They have like competitions here. It's amazing. And yeah, you know, it's nice to look at, I guess. Number 12, getting coffee to go. Another big, big yes. A lot of people take their coffee to go. I think it has to do because most of the Americans have a very, very long commute, right? They sit in the car for 1.5, 2 hours to go to work sometimes, which is normal for most Americans. And I think that's the reason why you take your coffee to go. They take the coffee to go, not just like from a restaurant or from a drive-through Starbucks. They make their coffee at home and then they take that mug into their car. I've seen it so many times in the US. That's not a very common thing in Europe to do. You drink your coffee either at the bar in the morning where you have breakfast or at home before you leave. So, and number 13, obviously having drive-throughs. Yeah, that's another very common thing. Everything has a drive-thru in the US. Franchise restaurants, of course, fast food, 100%. But yeah, Starbucks, Dunkin', a lot of things. Just very common. Again, they spend a lot of time in their car. I get it. 14, we did already talk about this. Always having the AC running. Yes, 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 yes. And I, like I said in the video before, and I'm going to link the video right here again in the description. I don't know if I'm ever going to get used to the AC all day long. It's just so weird. But, you know, it gets really hot. So I think that's a solution right there. Number 15, shopping in superstores. Yeah, it's another very common thing in the US, especially Costco, Walmart, Target. Those are just humongous stores where you can find anything. Like, it doesn't matter if you need a fire extinguisher or cat food or water or birthday cards. It doesn't matter. They have everything. It's insane. It is convenient, to be honest, because you go to one place and you find most of the things, all of the things you need, for sure. So it has its good and bad sides, both. Number 16, shopping at pharmacies that are mini shopping malls. Yeah, pharmacies are huge in the US. I think pharmaceutical products in general, every Target, every Walmart has its own pharmacy department. The actual pharmacies are huge. Medicine and prescription medicine is big here in the US. A lot of people take medicine and vitamins and everything. And I don't know how healthy that is and how good it is, how necessary it is, to be honest. But that's just my personal opinion, you know. Otherwise, you know, everyone makes its own choice, so. Number 17, eating supersized portions. Yeah, also very, very common, very normal thing. Portions are always huge, and it's also normal to take it home. You're never gonna finish it. Yeah, that happens a lot in major restaurants. Portions are just huge. I don't know. It's just part of the culture, right? So, number 18, we did talk about this as well, dining with over-attentive servers. I hate to say, but they're so eager on that tip that they just want to be fast, extremely good, and they want you out of there as fast as possible so they can serve the next table. And I hate it. It's my pet peeve. I already talked about this. You know, if I go to a restaurant, it's a service. I should take however much time I want. I can eat whatever I want, and I shouldn't be bothered consistently by people asking me if I need anything else. I will let you know. At least that's how we do it in Europe. Here it's a little different. You know, we have to adapt. It's America. I'm not gonna change the culture. I don't want to. So I'll just keep doing what I do, and they keep doing what they do. Number 19, getting constant water refills. Yeah, like general refills, water. I talked about this in the video before. You go to a restaurant and before you even sit down, people order water and then they keep bringing water, tap water consistently. Like it's a cycle, just normal. It's part of the service, I think. Number 20, another thing that I hate, putting ice in water. Well, basically in everything. Ice is like, I don't know, I don't like it. I don't want to have it in my drink, but here it goes with everything. It's funny. It's really interesting. No matter what you drink, yeah, water, whiskey, soda. Number 21. Yeah, offering so many choices. Yeah, unless you go to a high-end restaurants where you have obviously just a certain amount of dishes. If you go to general restaurants, diners, endless. Like, you get a card that is just basically humongous and will never stop and never end, and it's gonna take you forever to find what you want. Now, here is the surprising question: how fresh can all this food be if they offer all these things? Who knows? Number 22, going big with tips. Yep, mentioned this before again. Tips, it's a huge thing. I don't like it the way people tip here, and I don't know. I think there should be a little restaurant reform, but you know, politically, the US is busy with other things right now, so let's push that a little up for later. Number 23, we also talked about this, giving away your credit card. Yeah, that doesn't happen in Europe. Like, they come with that little machine to the table, you put your card in, you sign it or put your PIN. Here, you give them your credit cards and it disappears for a couple of minutes, which can be really scary, in my opinion. Like, you know how many things you can purchase in like 5 minutes on Amazon with a credit card? It's insane. So, number 24, yes, I love this. Having lawyers that advertise. It's so funny. Again, if you're European and you were young and you saw Breaking Bad, right, and you see the Better Call Saul advertisement, you think that's a movie thing, right? In every movie that you see all this like bail bond advertisement and get you out of jail lawyer and all these things. It's a thing here in the US, it really is. They advertise their business, you know, you should get a lawyer for everything. But you also have to go to court for everything, I think, in the US. Number 25, prescription drug makers that advertise. Yes, that's another thing that advertises, prescription medication, prescriptive. Whatever, prescripted, you know what I mean. They advertise on TV on like, but even with the disclaimer like, oh, you know, this is prescription based, please consult your, I'm like, why are you even advertising if people can't buy it? Like, this is just my marketing thinking is, you're spending money to advertise something that people might need, don't know if they need unless somebody tells them and signs that they need it. You know? It's a very American thing. I don't really understand it, but it's fine with me. It doesn't bother me, you know? Number 26, wearing pajamas in public. Well, you know, I live in California, so people dress a little different anyway. You know, it's a little, everything is a little more chill here, I think. But I don't think they wear pajamas in public. I would be lying if I said, oh yes, that's a thing. I don't know. I can't really talk about it, but please let me know if you know anything about it. Number 27, drinking wine from a 3-liter bottle. I don't know. I haven't really seen it. My only thought can be, I think Americans like to buy things in bulk. They like to buy big packages of things. because it lasts longer, so they don't have to go shopping too often, probably. I don't know. I'm just trying to put a theory together here. So that's my only explanation why they would drink from bigger bottles. I don't know. Let me know, guys. Number 28, deep frying everything. Yeah, it is. I think it's a very common thing. Fried food is a big thing in the US. I mean, it's good. Honestly, there's a lot of, you can deep fry a lot of things that are really good that you would think it wouldn't be. I had once fried pickles and they're amazing. Like, seriously, they're so good. And you would think, what, why? But they really are. Super healthy? No, but still good. Number 29, driving on wide roads. Yep, again, it's a very common thing. And we know this from the movies, right? You see those highways with like 6-7 lanes on each side. They're like huge. And then you get to the US and you actually see those roads. It's just so incredible. It's a very interesting experience to see those humongous roads for the first time. Oh, number 30 is also very, very American, I think. Having huge gaps in the toilet doors. It's so weird, but it's true. A lot of places where you go to toilets in restaurants, public toilets, schools, you close the door and there is always like this gap that you can literally look through and see who is sitting there. I don't understand why. It would be fun to see why things are the way they are, but I don't know. Number 31, oh, my favorite candy. Eating grape flavor Skittles. I think Skittles are big everywhere, all over the world probably. Grape flavored, I didn't know that was a special thing here in the US. I like them all. I never really thought of Skittles. Oh, grape is more prominent in the US than it's in Europe or whatever. I can't really talk about it. I love it. I think they're amazing. Skittles are great. My favorite candy. And that's all I can say about it. 32, keeping eggs in the refrigerator. What? Keeping eggs in the refrigerator. I did not know that was a thing here. Why would you do that? I don't know, guys. Let me know what you guys think. If that's really a thing in the US or I'm just like being weird. And number 33, last fact. Pronouncing the last letter of the alphabet as Z. That's right. We learn the alphabet and that last letter is a Z. And I know that from speaking to English people, to South African, I think Australian. Most of the people that speak English call it Z. And then you go to the US and it's Z. It's America. It's the country of individualism and doing what you think is right. So I think that's what they thought. It's like that last letter. We're not gonna call it Z. We are rebels. We call it Z. That's it. With the Z and the Z, we are gonna finish this video, guys. Thank you very, very much for watching this all the way until the end. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe again, like this video, and share it if you can. And I would love to read some of the comments. Let me know what you think, if you experience both places, if you live in the US. How much of this is true, how much isn't? I would love to hear some feedback from you. Till then, make sure you stay healthy out there, stay safe, and take care. See you soon.